I never got to say what I want to.
Oh my God, oh my God,
I'm not the same as I was with you. I would jump out my skin just to get you.
Hey guys, and welcome back to our channel. So in this video, I'm going to be doing this makeup look right here. I did post a picture up on Instagram of this same look. It was probably like 2 o'clock in the morning and I was just playing around with my makeup, trying to come up with new things, and I actually really like it. It's very soft and pretty with a kind of heavy lower lash line, which I absolutely love. This is like the perfect makeup look that I would wear for like a wedding, anniversary, Valentine's. I know those things are not anywhere near or on our schedule right now. I know most people are thinking about Halloween, but anyways, this is kind of my comfort zone of what I like. I'm gonna stop rambling now and just jump right into the video. Guys, please don't forget to subscribe, follow us on Instagram, like the video, and comment down below anything you guys want. So I'm just gonna stop talking now and just jump right into the video. So to start this look, I am going to moisturize first, like I always do, and I'm going to be using the Neutrogena Hydro Boost Water Gel. I've been using this for a while now. I do like it. I don't know if I like it more than my Lubriderm Extra Dry Skin. If you guys have been watching our channel since we started, that's what I've been using since, but I don't know. I like it more than this one. I'm going to move on to primer, and I'm using my Smashbox Photo Finish Primer, and all I like to do is just take a little bit and just warm it up in my hand and apply most of the product like on my nose and my T-zone, and then whatever is left, I'm just going to apply a thin layer on the rest of my face. For foundation, I'm going to be using my favorite. This is my Maybelline Fit Me, the Matte and Poreless, in the color Golden Caramel, which is 332. I absolutely love this foundation. I do have like normal to dry skin, and I don't really have an issue with this foundation. I know they recommend you not to use it if you do have dry skin, but I do. It's never been an issue. And I'm just going to put a little bit on my Real Technique sponge and kind of just dot this all over my face and then just pounce it in. Now that I have my foundation on, I'm going to move on to concealer, and this is my LA Girl Pro Concealer in the color Pure Beige, and I'm just going to apply this on the normal places that you would put your concealer. So under my eyes, I'm going to apply a little bit on the bridge of my nose as well as my forehead and chin area. Now using my Real Technique sponge again, I'm just going to blend that in. To set everywhere I put that concealer, I'm going to go in with my Wet n Wild contouring palette in the color Caramel Toffee with a Zoeva 112 brush, and just pick up the banana shade, and I'm going to actually really bake under my eyes and let that powder sit there. To set the rest of my face, I'm going to use my Milani Multitasker face powder like I always do. I need to go buy another one because, hello, it's basically almost done. I'm like using the little product that's left on the very edges. And by the way, this is Azo Evo 103 brush. Really like it for when I'm setting the rest of my face. It does a really good job. I'm gonna finally move on to my eyes. My nose is scratching. Okay, anyways, I'm going to move on to my eyes and I'm using my Morphe 35O palette. You guys know I love this palette. I know for like the past couple tutorials, I've been only using this palette because it's so good. And if you don't have it, I really suggest you go pick up because it's just everything that you would probably want. But anyways, I'm going to actually set my lids using a Zoeva 142 brush, and I'm using this color right here. This is a concealer buffer brush actually, but I really like it for when I'm just applying a setting powder on my lids because it does it really quickly and I don't have to spend too much time doing this. Now to actually start the eye look, I'm gonna go in with my Sigma E40 and pick up this shadow right here. And as you guys can tell, I used that banana shade in the Wet n Wild contouring palette and I kind of just like sharpened the edges. So if you don't want to use tape or if that's something that you're into, you can use your banana powder and just sharpen up the edges so it can be like a guide for you. So I'm just gonna take that light brown shadow and just place this in my crease. And I'm just gonna take my time and blend the shadow. Now going into this color right here, I'm basically going to put this color directly where we put that first transition shade, but I'm just going to apply it a little bit lower with the same Sigma E40. I'm gonna go in and switch brushes. I'm using a smaller tapered blending brush and I'm going to pick up this shadow right here on the very tip of the brush. You wanna tap off the excess and I'm gonna place most of the color in the outer V of my crease. And I'm really taking my time and applying a little bit of color at a time and then building it up. I'm gonna go back in with my Sigma E40 and take a mixture of these two shadows right here. And just make sure all of those edges are nice and blended and there are no sharp lines. If you feel like you went over that like sharp line or guideline that we did with our banana powder, you can go over it with more powder. And I'm actually gonna do that because I feel like I did. So I'm just going to use my MAC 239 brush, and you can go back in with the same powder, but since I'm holding the Morphe 35O palette, I'm going to pick up this shadow right here, which is pretty much a banana shade, and just sharpen the edge up. And now go in with my Zoeva 226 brush and pick up a little bit of the shadow right here. It's like a pinky shimmery shadow, and just highlight my brow bone with this shadow. Highlight color, I'm going to be using a highlight from ColourPop. This is a cream highlight in the color Wisp. It's just absolutely beautiful. And how I'm going to apply this is actually use my finger and just apply this on my lids. This is so pigmented and it just feels so nice when you rub your fingers through it. Now to set that cream, I'm going to pick up this shadow right here, and this is a Zoeva 234 brush, and I'm just going to lightly pack this all over my lid. I'm just gonna go back in with my Sigma E40 with no additional product and just blend out those edges. Moving on to a liner, I'm using my Kat Von D Tattoo Liner in the color Trooper, and I'm just going to draw on a regular wing. I'm gonna move on to my lashes. I'm gonna curl them really quickly. This is a lash curler from Beauty 360. I'm going to apply my lashes off camera only because it's easier for me. The lashes that I'm going to be using are actually customized lashes that I made myself. The baselines are my Ardell Demi Wispies, and I just applied some like individual. So lashes are on. I'm just going to take the same brush that I used to set my entire face. I don't have any additional products left, but whatever is left on it, I'm going to use that to kind of just dust away that bakeage I had under my eye. My Wet n Wild contouring palette in the contouring shade, and I'm using my Zoeva 109 brush, and I'm just gonna speed right through this. I'm going to be using this Jane Iredell blush product. This is in the color Sheer Honey with my Zoeva 127 brush. For highlight, I'm going to first go in with the ColourPop cream highlight in the color Wisp again. And I'm just going to apply this on the very high points of my cheeks. Going to set that using Champagne Pop with my Soeva fan brush. I'm gonna move back onto my eyes, and I'm gonna take my e.l.f. cream liner in black with a angled brush. And I'm just going to place this in my waterline. To blend out that black waterline that we applied, I'm going to take a mixture of these two shadows at the bottom here with a Soeva 227 brush, tap off the excess, and just run that all over your little lash line. Up the eyes, I'm going to apply some mascara to my top and bottom lashes, and this is the Estee Lauder Sumptuous Gold Volume Lifting Mascara. Now again, I'm just going to apply this to my tops and bottom lashes. I'm gonna first go in with the ColourPop Ultra Matte Lippy in the color Bieber, and I'll apply that all over my lips. And then over that, I'm gonna go in with the NYX Liquid Suede in the color Sandstorm and just apply that right over.